चाय भूतले श्रीमती भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी नामिनी नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पश्चात्य देश तारिणे ओम ज्ञानत्यमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजन शलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरुवे नमः। श्री चैतन्य मनोभीष्टं स्थापितमेन भूतले स्वयं रूप कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदांतिकम् वंदेगम श्रीगुरु श्रीयुत पद कमलम श्रीगुरून् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सकगण रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजन सहितं कृष्ण चैतन्य देवं श्रीराधा कृष्ण पादान् सकगण ललिता श्री विशाखान्वितांश्च हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीनबंधु जगत्पदे गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमोऽस्तुते। तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसूते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिन्धुभ्येव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभो नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। ईश्वर परम कृष्ण सच्चिदानंद विग्रह अनादिराधिर गोविंद सर्व कारण कारणम हरे कृष्ण। बाय द कॉसलेस मर्सी ऑफ द सुप्रीम पर्सनालिटी ऑफ गॉड श्री कृष्ण वी आर नाइसली स्टडीइंग भगवद्गीता। सो वी आर इन द 12th चैप्टर ऑफ भगवद्गीता डिवोशनल सर्विस भक्ति योग। सो वी हैव ऑलरेडी फिनिश्ड अबाउट 11 श्लोकास इन दिस चैप्टर। So Krishna is now teaching us what we should do. And if you are not able to follow what Krishna says, then at least Krishna is giving relaxations. Basically, Krishna is relaxing the rules, relaxing the like what our sadhana, what the practice, basically what we can do. So that way, everything we are directly hearing from Krishna, that's what is very important. Because this knowledge is coming from the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Sri Krishna direct. When we understand everything from Krishna and just follow in our life, so we are going to free ourselves from this material bondage, material body. Our only problem is having this material body. That's what is our problem. So there is no point in wasting our life, this human life, in going after material sense objects and taking care of our material body all the time. Of course, we need to take care to a certain extent so that our body works very well. Really speaking, by working so hard, by going after material properties, material things in this world, in fact, we are doing the otherwise, we are doing the opposite. We are not taking care of our body very well. That's what is happening in general. For the body, it's a machine. So this machine just needs very good, healthy food to work properly. So for example, any machine, when you want to, for example, the car, when you want to change the oil, so you are looking for even the synthetic oil, the best oil, something like that, you are getting it so that it will work better. So when you want to buy something outside for anything, we are always trying to get the best thing. So similarly, for the body, we need to give the best food. That's what is very important. If you eat junk food, that's not at all good for body. Body doesn't like it because we are forcing the body to digest. We are forcing the stomach and our digestion system to really digest such kind of very junk food. So we need to eat healthy food that is in the mode of goodness. So that way we can take care of the body. So that way these vegetables and fruits are really not that expensive at all compared to the packaged food. And all such things, they are very expensive actually. So if we buy all the vegetables and fruits and if we cook and eat and offer to Krishna and take prasadam, we can actually save a lot of money actually. And it's so good for health also. compared to eating from outside, fast food restaurants, this and that and all such things. So that way, we need to realize and understand that this human body, this human life is a very special opportunity for us, and we cannot waste this opportunity. So that way, we just need to only take care of our body to the extent that we lead a healthy life. And then we need to take care of our mind. So we need to take care of our sleep. So that way our brain will be very active. So that's why sleep also is very important. So that way we need to understand this Bhagavad Gita and follow what Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita. So then we will be able to do all these things. So that way we can make use of this body very well, so that we will not get another body. That's what is very important. Because the problem is then again we need to take care of the another body also. Then again, we need to struggle. So we need to die. So we need to realize that having this body is our real problem. Material body is our real problem. We need to now free ourselves from this body. So this is bondage. This is known as Janma Bandha, bondage to birth in this material world. We need to free ourselves from this bondage, this Janma Bandha. How are we going to do? So we need to develop Krishna Bandha. We need to develop attachment to Krishna. That means we need to develop attachment to Krishna as well. So that means our mind should be constantly focusing on only Krishna only. Our mind should be always connected with Krishna only. The only way we can think about Krishna all the time, when we are able to do what Krishna told us to do, what Krishna has asked us to do. If we are able to do that, so then we will be able to think about Krishna all the time. And where Krishna is giving us the guidance, instructions? In this Bhagavad Gita. So in Bhagavad Gita, which is the song of God, so the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Sri Krishna, is very clearly telling us what to do, what we need to do. So, that way, if you understand all these slokas and just do according to what Krishna is asking us to do, so then that means we will be able to remember Krishna, we will be able to forget about this material world. So we'll be able to free ourselves from this material bondage. So that way we will be able to be always connected with Krishna. That's what is very important. So studying Bhagavad Gita, understanding Bhagavad Gita and following Bhagavad Gita and spreading Bhagavad Gita. So this is the best way for us to be in constant contact with Krishna. Continuous contact with Krishna. That way we are listening to Krishna all the time. By studying this Bhagavad Gita, we are listening to Krishna all the time. So we are always connected with Krishna with this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. So that opportunity Krishna has given to us. So now, by properly making use of this opportunity, we will be able to get a life in Krishna's world, so that we will not be forced to accept another material body in this material world. So then our problem is solved. Our problem is having this material body. That's what is our problem. The main problem is only having ourselves stuck inside this material body. We need to solve this problem forever. And the major problem is that this is happening forever. We are repeatedly taking bodies after bodies in this material world. Body after body. Birth after birth. And then die. So it's not at all fun being get ourselves stuck inside this material body. That's what we need to understand. So we are bonded, we are bound, we are glued to this body. This Atma is glued to this body. By Karma Bandha, Janma Bandha, all such things. So how are we going to free ourselves from this material body? That's what is very important. So we need to make use of this human life only for their purpose. That is possible only by just following all the instructions given by Krishna in Bhagavad Gita completely, as it is. Then we will be in, as I said in the very beginning, we will be in contact with Krishna. We'll be able to remember Krishna. So that way we will be able to forget this material world. So then we can go to Krishna as well, Goloka. And time is very fast. Time flies very, very fast. So very soon we will also have to leave from this world. That means we need to change bodies. Change a body. Deginoshmin yata dege kaumaram yavvanam jara tatha dega antara praptir dhirastatra namukhyati. So we are already continuously changing body in this, within this body. This soul is continuously changing the body. We have not seen any machine doing like that. We make so many machines, and when it doesn't work, we'll throw it away and get another machine. But this body is a machine which is continuously changing itself. But the problem is, it is designed. This machine is designed to work only for a certain period of time. Because afterwards, when we get old, the cells won't grow that fast. The metabolism will be very slow. We cannot eat that much. We cannot digest that much. And we cannot be very active. So then our senses also will become very weak. We cannot see things. We cannot hear things. So all these problems will happen to this body. Then at one point of time, this body will fail. It will stop working. The heart will stop beating. So that's the time we need to leave this place. So that way, everyone is going to die. No one is going to live here forever. So there is no point in thinking somebody is really so rich or so powerful. All such things are all nonsense. You should not be thinking like that at all. There is no need to envy someone who is really very rich or someone who is really very powerful, all such things. Because everyone is going to die. That's the main thing. It doesn't matter whether we are really leading a very opulent life, very rich life in this world. It doesn't matter. Even if we live up to 100 years also, it doesn't matter. We are going to die. That's what is very important. So we need to solve the problem of not coming back to this world again. We need to stop that. We need to stop this nonsense. We need to solve that problem so that we will not come back to this world again. So when this time is available for us, right now is the time, good time for us. This is the best time for us to effectively make use of this Bhagavad Gita and connect with Krishna and spread Bhagavad Gita and make as many devotees as possible and be always in contact with Krishna. This is the best time. Right now is the best time. We should go to Krishna. We should go to Goloka. We should remember Krishna all the time. So that way we need to make as much as progress as possible in this life itself. If possible, we should directly go to Krishna in this life itself. Iha ivataigi jitaga sargau yesam samye sthitam managa nirdosham hi samam brahma tasmat brahmani te sthitaha. Iha ivataigi jitaga sargau. So in this life itself, we need to Jitaga Sarga means we need to win. We need to conquer the repeated birth in this world. Jitaga Sarga. Yesam Samye Sitam Managa. Those who are mind. So those who have controlled their mind. Nirdoshamgi. Without any faults. Without any attachments to this material world. Nirdoshamgi. Samam Brahma. So being equal. Tasmat Brahmani Te Sitaga. So that way they are actually situated in the Brahman platform. Tasmat Brahmani Te Sitaga. So if you are able to achieve that Brahman platform, if you are able to stay in that Brahman status, so then at the end of our death, when the death comes, we will be going to Krishna as well. So we need to achieve that Brahman realizes that Brahman status, basically that we are not the body, we are the soul, and Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. We don't belong to this material world. So we don't need this human body. We don't have to take birth again and again in this material world and suffer and again. So all these things, knowledge, we need to get from this Bhagavad Gita completely. and then fully make use of this opportunity to go to Goloka, Krishna's will. Krishna has given us, when we are very much interested in doing this to progress, then we are interested in progressing in this effort, then Krishna is going to provide all the resources and opportunities for us. We really don't have to struggle very hard to earn our daily bread. We really don't have to struggle very hard in our life. There is absolutely no need to get stressed on anything. There is no need to think or worry about anything. If we just depend on Krishna, if we just focus on Krishna, by Krishna's causeless mercy, we will be able to make use of this life very, very nicely. And as Krishna says that, Bahunam janmanam ante jnanavan mam prabhatyate vasudevam sarvam iti samahatma sudullabha. So we need to simply surrender unto Krishna. Vasudevam sarvam iti mam prabhatyate. So we need to surrender unto Krishna, knowing that Vasudeva, Krishna is everything. So that's what we need to do. That is definitely going to happen with the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. It is happening by Krishna's mercy. It is happening, and we will do that. We will surrender unto Krishna. There is no doubt about it. When we keep on studying this Bhagavad Gita like this, we are studying every day. We are studying every day. We are focusing. We are making progress. We are understanding all the slokas. And whatever slokas we have already studied, we should keep going through it. So anytime, whenever we get the time, we need to keep going through all these slokas, what we have studied, because we are studying very deep. Each and every sloka we are understanding very nicely. So that way we should keep studying, remembering, understanding this Bhagavad Gita by Krishna's causeless mercy. Krishna will provide us more and more opportunities to please Him, to serve Him. So that way Krishna will make sure that we are in constant contact with Him. So that's what will happen. When we just this studying Bhagavad Gita alone is going to take us to that stage. Just fully focusing, fully having ourselves, having complete faith on this Bhagavad Gita and fully focus on studying this Bhagavad Gita, that's what is going to take us to Krishna's well, Goloka. Idam jnanam upashitya mama sadharmyam agata sadgepi nopadaye nopajayante pralaye navyatanti cha. That's what Krishna says. Now in the 12th chapter in the Bhakti Yoga, Krishna is teaching us that you try to do this. If you can't do this, at least do this. If you can't do that, at least do this. Like that Krishna is teaching us. We already studied, starting from the 8th sloka onwards. In the 8th sloka, Krishna taught us that always you fix your mind upon me, focus your intelligence upon me. By doing so, you will live in me, you will come to me. That's what Krishna says. Then in the 9th sloka, Krishna said that if you are not able to do, if you are not able to remember focusing your mind upon me, then abhyasa, then you do practice. So by practicing, then you will be develop a desire to come to me. Maam ichchaptum dhananjaya. Abhyasa yogena tato maam ichchaptum dhananjaya. So then Krishna is saying that if you are not able to do that abhyasa, then directly engage in my devotional service. Abhyase pe asamattosi matkarma paramobhava. So directly focus in my job. So devotional service, matkarma paramobhava. Madattam api karmani kurvan siddhim avapsasi. So if you work for me, then you will achieve perfection. If you can't do that also, atetatapi asaktosi, atetatapi asaktosi kartum madyogam asitaga sarva karma palatyagam tatakuru yatatmavan. So you give up sarva karma palatyagam. If you are not able to directly engage in my devotional service, then you give up all the attachments to the results. So sarva karma palatyagam tathakuru yathatmavan. So be situated in the self. So now Krishna is teaching. Krishna is basically all these 4 slokas what we studied, 8, 9, 10, 11. So everything together Krishna is telling in the next sloka, summarizing. These 4 slokas Krishna is summarizing and telling in the 12th sloka. That's what we are going to study in the 8th chapter, 12th sloka. Sreyo hi jnanam abhyasat jnanat dhyanam visishyati dhyanat sarva karma dhyanat karma palatyagas tyagat shantir anantaram. Sreyo hi jnanam abhyasat. So if you are not able to do this abhyasa, then at least gain the knowledge. That's what this Bhagavad Gita is better. It's better if you are not able to do abhyasa, if you are not able to do practice. So sreyo hi jnanam abhyasa. Jnana dhyanam visishyate. So just getting the knowledge alone is not going to help us. Of course, we need to follow. So following this, this dhyana, that's what Krishna said in the very beginning, that you fix your mind upon me, focus your mind upon me. So this abhyasa, you have everything. So that's why Krishna is again repeating that jnana dhyanam visishyati. So se yogi jnanam abhyasa jnana dhyanam visishyati dhyana karma pala tyagas. So dhyana meditation, if you are not able to fully meditate on me 24/7, if you are not able to do that, so then you give up the attachment to the results of the activities. Because by doing so, tyaga shantir anantaram, by doing this tyaga, by renouncing the results, by renouncing the attachment to the results, you are going to get shanti. You are going to get peace, peace of mind. So that's what Krishna is saying. Shantir anantaram. So that way, we just have to, if you are able to, that's why chanting Hare Krishna at least 1 hour, like 16 rounds a day. So we should follow. So definitely when we get old, when we are not able to, very especially when we retire, when we don't have anything to do, there is nothing else. We should not be thinking that there is nothing else. We should be very, very busy in doing this dhyana, meditating on Krishna, remembering Krishna, forgetting about this material world completely, because anyhow we will be kicked out of this body. There is no point in thinking or remembering about anything in this material world. We need to disconnect, completely detach. So, but depending upon our age, depending upon what we can do, so we can, but definitely chant Hare Krishna every day. That's very important. But we need to do service, devotional service. So the very important devotional service is spreading this message, this Bhagavad Gita to everywhere. So if we are engaged in this service very nicely, very clearly, then we are going to go to Goloka. There is no doubt about it. So by Krishna's causeless mercy, we have successfully finished 12th sloka in the 12th chapter, Hare Krishna. I'll stop now. We'll discuss if any questions are there. Hare Krishna.